I'm going to put this at the start. This is for Rhonda Ryan. Thank you for all your support. You comment on me music channel all the time and stuff, so I thought I'd do it for you.
I'm energized. I've came back to life, reborn in a whole new line. No enemies inside. Amen.
What up, guys? It's David Joe. Welcome back to Jot That Back. I did have this reaction recorded earlier on, but errors happened. My phone was deciding to be a bit of a you-know-what. I'm trying not to swear in the first minute. So I decided to re-record it, but do a different version. And it's the same version, but a remastered. It looks better. I just thought I'd let you know that this was the most stressful day ever. But I'm still here, still ready to go, still battling through. And we're going to do Flick of the Wrist at the Rainbow, 1974. I am actually right as well, because on my first version, I didn't know it was a Rainbow or not. It just said Live, 1974. So it's quite late, so I'm just going to tone it down a little bit. I like these sort of reactions anyways. Subscribe if you're new. We're not on the road to 2k. We'll be on the road to 3k. Just subscribe anyways. Subscribe. Follow me socials. It will be linked in the description. Anything helps. So thank you. But anyways, let's get straight into it. Queen, Flick of the Wrist, Live at the Rainbow. Looking forward to this one again. Let's do it.
And this is the side which you haven't been hearing on the Tony Blackburn show. It's called Flick of the Wrist. Thank you.
I said this in the original version that I've done. The fact he's playing them keys so fast with one hand as well, while just multitasking, got the mic ready to sing. So incredible, man. The audio sounds much better on this one, so I'm actually quite glad I've done this again. Jacka Batlow, I love the lyrics on this. Get very Ozzy Osbourne vibes off this song. Said this previously again, the lyrics on this are really good. One thing I wish I would have done though, and I am gonna do actually, is react to the official version as well, so I can read the lyrics. But from the little bits I'm picking up, it's a really good song. I love Freddie's lyrics so much. The way he can make a story and tell a story through his songs was so good, considering he used to write about such broad subjects. He was really good at doing it. Like, he could write personal. He was just such a gifted writer. Like, he's just a natural writer and a natural musician, from what I've seen later on in this video. Jacket. I like it because the way he switches his vocals so fast on that bit there, because he's, you know, he's spitting out the lyrics at a high volume in front of the going, like, really nice. You know, one thing I've figured out about Freddie, right? His 70s stuff, he was surprisingly clean. Like, it was only the 80s where he really, well, maybe the late 70s, early 80s. But in this era, I've realised that every song and every the way he sounded back then was very clean. There wasn't much rasp there. And now, all of a sudden, I was a massive fan of Freddie's clean voice. And I think that kind of came back in the later years. Obviously, he had his rasp, but when he was hitting high notes, he was really good at hitting high notes clean. And he just got a really nice clean voice. He could do both. Obviously, he was good at the distortion as well, but his clean voice is just so underrated, I think. I love his clean voice.
It's
lyric there, intoxicate your brain with what I'm saying. I think that's the lyric. It's just so true to Freddie as well. Jack a back for the lyric, man. Jack! You heard that guitar of the really dark, morbid Ozzy Osbourne Black Sabbath fades I get off this. Really nice. Jack it back again, man. Jack it! Another great lyric. Prostitute yourself, castrate your human pride. What the fuck, like, such a great lyric. If it was earlier on and I could really hype it up, I would, but it's really late. Really great lyrics on this one. Sacrifice your leisure day, then it's really easy till you try. Down the back, it's a river. That's one thing I said in the previous video, sorry to keep referring back to it, but I really need to emphasize this. The fact he sings and then switches to the piano and just plays it like nothing's a matter, usually with like an amateur. I've made mistakes like this where I've been with a band, I've been in a couple of bands when I was a kid and stuff, and effortlessly switching from singing to then doing this or doing that. I never done it myself, but even I would miss a cue vocally because the acoustics and everything, you're put off by the ambience, the atmosphere of where you are. He was just so good at like controlling that though, switching from singing, getting himself into a singing vibe as well, switching from vibe to vibe and molding it into one. Only Freddie could do that. And I'm guessing that's his roadie that took his mic there. Jesus Christ, man. Such a human metronome, jack it back. Jack it! Referring to my old point here. The ambience, the vibe of the room, he's live, he's in front of loads of people, you'd expect like some hiccups, wouldn't you? Like with a normal band, but Queen are just not a normal band. We're never normal and never will be in every good way possible. The way you could just zone in and focus on putting the best musical display for the fans out there possible. He was just so on the button, he'd never missed a beat, never missed a beat. Even the switch there, even the switch, he slowed it down, did, and broke it down. Jack it back. And Brian's just as good. All of these guys are on point right now. Always have been though. Jack it back. Brian's guitar solo coming through is so nice. Jack it! You know, the thing is as well, right, it's not as if these guys are playing easy notes. It's not as like a dinner, like a simple one, two, three, four pattern. It's like Freddie is skipping, doing Freddie's, you know, Freddie's piano playing. He's got such a signature sound. He's one of a kind him when it comes to piano playing. He's, in my eyes, anyways, in my ears, he's very aggressive with his style of playing. He's got such a signature sound, Freddie Mercury. He's really good at stamping his own sound when it came to piano. But it's not just the fact he's hitting one chord like all the time. He's skipping, he's doing what Freddie does. That diverse, unexplainable, unique like style of piano playing. And then Brian May's coming in with his solo, and then John's coming in with these pumpy bass lines, and Roger's doing his drums. It's like a spider web molded into a circle. It's just so dynamic but so put together at the same time. My face.
with pain. Shoot me without
end. Do you see what I mean? The fact that you could just go from doing that absolute masterpiece of piano work to just gives a night back, bang, back into the singing element, and he keeps it all in one element. There's no signs of cracking or I'm a bit late, nothing. He's just so on the button, along with everyone else, but it'll be harder for him, because he's got to do two things at once, you know what I mean?
Just to my bones, scream with pain, to make the impression.
Sorry, a pause here, alright, but I love the guitar, the way it goes. Really dark and metally. I love it. Love the way he does that. The way the fact it's so glued together, his vocals, and it goes, he opens up a little bit. Really nice way there. Listen carefully. So beautiful, it's so like whimsy, you know what I mean? It's so like brittle, but in a good way. It's so artistically pleasing to hear as an artist. So catchy that bit there. Flick of the wrist, da-na-da-da-na. Jabba. A lovely note there, Jatterbach, there. Yeah, and I can't do it loud because it's late, but yeah, Jatterbach. Lovely.
Baby, you've been Thank you. Now then.
I'm glad I heard that bit at the end, actually. Literally, his laugh at the end encapsulates that performance and Freddie Mercury in general and Queen. Like, the fact he knows he's just smashed it there. You know what I mean? He knows he's just put a banger live. I mean, that was a great performance there. I literally reacted to this early on tonight. But the good thing about Queen is that when you come back to it, it's like reacting all over again. Effortless as well, the fact that you could focus on two things. I know multitasking for some people is quite easy, but to do it on that scale with everything going on around you, you're live, anything could happen, the nerves, anything. He just went for it. He just smashed it and was pitch perfect. On the button, metronome, the human metronome for a reason. Everything was on the button. And the way he was playing as well, it wasn't just like I say, it wasn't just a simple little few chords. He's like, he's full on going for it. And all of a sudden, back into the mic and he's singing his heart out. It's just so, so great. Four people produced all of that. Like, four people. You'd expect an orchestra and a group of producers, 10-20 producers in the room to even fit them parts together, and they've done it as a four piece. Absolutely incredible. It shows how great they were. But anyways, I am gonna go now. Hope you enjoyed it. Guys, I'll see you next time. Peace.
Into another life, I survive another night, where I can fight for us, when I can handle us.